Welcome back. In the previous video, we had this very positive scenario where I had originally bought a house for $1.5 million. But then a year later, the value of the house, or at least my perceived value of the house, went up to $1.5 million because my neighbor sold their identical house for $1.5 million. And so my initial equity investment went from $250,000 to $750,000. And why is that? Well, equity is nothing but if I have an asset that's worth $1.5 million, and I owe $750,000, that was $750,000, that was my original mortgage on that asset, then what I'm left with is the equity. So my equity just tripled. It went from $250,000 to $750,000. In this video, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you, well, what can you do with that equity? I mean, it's not cash. It's kind of like this make-believe amount of wealth that you have. You just feel richer. And I'll show you that you can actually turn it into cash using something called a home equity loan. And I'd argue that this is actually what drove our economy from about 2002 to probably still to this day, although I think we're in a recession now. In fact, I'm about 100% sure we are, but definitely until about 2006. So what's a home equity loan? Well, I go to the bank and I say, "Wow, bank, I have all this. I have the $750,000 of equity. I wish, you know, I'm rich, but I don't have this it in cash. I want to, you know, do something that with the equity. I would like to live like a rich person." And well, the bank says, "Sal, you know, you're right. You know, our only requirement is that you have $250,000. Our only requirement is that you have 25% equity in your house." Right? Because they want a cushion in case you can't pay and they get the house back and they have to foreclose and auction off the house, et cetera, et cetera. So they said, well, so we're willing to loan you up to 75% of the value of your house. So what's 75% of the value of my house? So let's see, 1.5 times 75%. Let's see, it'll be 750,000 plus half of 750,000. It'll be 1.075 million. I did that in my head. It could be wrong, but it's roughly the right number. So the bank says, "You know what? We're willing to lend you up to 75% of the value of your asset." And it's of course going to be guaranteed by this asset. So far, we lent you 750,000. So you have, let's see how much you have more that you can borrow from us. Minus, so that's we're talking in millions, so it's 0.7075. So that's what 300, that's 250 plus 75, so up to 325,000 more that you could borrow. And what is this? Where am I taking this money out of? Well, I'm essentially taking this money out of the equity of my house. And how does that make sense? Well, what's going to happen? Well, I still have a 1.5 million. Let's say I take this loan. Let's say I say, "Bank, great. I want $325,000 of cash. I want it right now." So what happens? Let me draw another series of another balance sheet. I've stopped using the word balance sheet, even though that was the original purpose of this whole discussion. Draw it a little bit bigger. Remember, liabilities plus equities are equal to assets. So what are my assets now? So now I have a $1.5 million house, and I also got $325,000 cash from the bank. So we could call that, you know, let's say $325K cash. Got it from the bank. Now, what are my liabilities? Well, I have the original mortgage on my house. The original mortgage is $750,000. This is liabilities on this side. Well, not the whole side. We're going to have equity down here. So just this is liability, $750,000. And then I took a new loan to get this $325,000 of cash. So I have a new loan here, about this that amount, $325,000. And this was a home equity loan. I took a loan against the equity that I have in my house. This was the equity in my house. So what's the leftover equity? So let me just make everything clear. These are the liabilities. These are assets. And equity is what you have left over. So what are my assets? I have 1.825 million in assets minus, now what are my liabilities? Minus 1.0, let's see, 075, right? That was the max that I could borrow. Liabilities, right? Assets minus liabilities is owner's equity. So let's see, 825 minus 75. I still have 750,000 of equity. And that makes sense. If I just enter into some transaction where I get cash in exchange for debt, my equity shouldn't change. But now what does happen? Well, I have this cash, and I'm feeling rich because I've never seen numbers like $750,000. And that neighbor, that new neighbor that just bought that house across right next door for $1.5 million, he just bought a beautiful new Hummer. And being a very down-to-earth person, I feel that I also deserve a Hummer like my neighbor because I am just as rich as they are. So I decide to go out and I'm going to spend $100,000 on the Hummer. Actually, let's not do a Hummer because a Hummer could actually be considered an asset. I want pure consumption, although I think a Hummer is pretty close as a car gets to pure consumption. Let's say that neighbor went on a round-the-world vacation for $100,000. And I, too, because I did nothing but sit on my house and made $500,000 last year, I feel that I also deserve a $100,000 vacation. So what I do is I take $100,000 of this cash. So I'm now left with just $225. And I have the great experience of going on a vacation. But of course, I didn't get any asset in return for that. Although you could maybe, your happiness maybe is an asset. I don't know. But it doesn't show up on your balance sheet. So we had $325 in cash, now we have $225 in cash. So our total liabilities go down by $100,000. So if our total assets went down by $100,000, what are our assets now? It's 1.725, right? Because we spent $100,000 of our cash. So what's going to be the liabilities and equity? Well, the liabilities won't change, right? Just because I went on a vacation, the bank's not going to say, hey, Sal, you owe us less money. I still owe the almost, $1.075 million. That $100,000 is going to come all out of my equity. So now, all of a sudden, I don't have $750,000. I only have $650,000. And you could do it. And this isn't the balance sheet just for my house. This is kind of my whole personal balance sheet. And now my whole personal balance sheet, what just happened? I just took some of that original equity that I had. I took $100,000 of it, turned it into cash, and just went on a great one-year-long vacation. And this is what home equity loans are. And this is what I would argue drove the economy, or at least took us into an expansionary stage from 2002-2003. Because if you remember, a lot of people were still getting laid off in 2002-2003, but consumer spending kept going up. So if people are earning less money or they don't even have a job, how is spending going up? Well, the values of their house went up and they borrowed against the value of their house. They took cash out of it and they used that cash to buy their Hummers, to go on vacation, to buy fancy clothes or whatever. And that drove the economy. And in the next video, I'll actually talk about maybe why those housing prices go up, or why they went up in particular during this housing boom, this one that we're definitely in the process of getting out of. See you in the next video.